During the climax of the original Scream movie, it was a huge twist to have somebody like Stu Macher actually helping Billy Loomis on his rampage of killings. Not only because we expected Billy more, but Stu was considered quite a popular character amongst the people of Woodsboro High. Everyone went to his party almost, and people seemed to respect him quite a lot. So when we as fans found out that he was responsible for the actual killings as well as Billy, it was quite a shock. But I find Stu one of the most interesting characters in the Scream universe, only because it's never overly clear why he would go to such lengths to start killing in the same way that Billy did. But in this video, I want to discuss why I believe that Stu helped Billy kill people in the first Scream movie. Hello everyone and welcome to Beyond the Mask, where we talk about all things Scream. If you are interested in Scream content or you just like Ghostface in general, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell icon to stay notified for future content. So we all remember at the end of the first Scream movie when Billy was revealed to be the killer, and then shortly afterwards it was revealed that Stu was also revealed to have been helping him. Billy later explained that his motive was that Sydney's mum, Maureen Prescott, had been having an affair with his dad, which caused his parents to split up and his mum left and left Billy alone. And on that fateful night that Maureen Prescott was dead, when Stu and Billy plotted to kill her together, that was only the beginning of the horrifying killings that were about to arrive in Woodsboro. But the reason for Stu to join Billy wasn't actually revealed. The only clue that was actually given as to why Stu did this for Billy was peer pressure.
Stu, what's your motive? Billy's got one, the police are on their way, what are you gonna tell them?
Peer pressure. I'm far too sensitive.
But I just want to point out that he said this on the phone to Sydney when he was bleeding and he was practically said he was dying, and I think that was all he was going to tell the police. But with all that we know in the film aside, I want to go more in depth and discuss what I think actually went on with Stu, and things that I noticed in the first Scream movie that maybe you guys didn't, and also shed light on why I think Stu was actually one of the best killers in the franchise. So ever since the first Scream movie and the reveal's been out, people have always talked about how great Billy was and how Billy being the killer was such a big thing and how he played the part so well and how he really was psychotic. But Billy had a motive for killing people, whereas Stu didn't actually have one on paper. It wasn't actually revealed in the film why he was doing this. I just want to point you guys into scenes in the first Scream movie. Upon reflection, you know, Stu's personality was quite fun and bubbly and people enjoyed him, and he seemed to be quite a hit with everyone in school, and he was a comedy element for Scream in some ways, I believe. But that being said, I also believe when you watch back and think about this in mind, that Stu's actual personality in the first Scream movie is sort of over the top, and he also has quite exaggerated mannerisms. But for me, that was a huge red flag, because all that implied to me was that he wasn't actually mentally stable, and it was completely believable that he was able to be manipulated by Billy in the first place. Others have pointed out to me that his relationship with Casey Becker was a motivation to kill, as it's mentioned that she dumped him for Stephen Orff, who also was killed at the start of the first Scream movie. But this wouldn't actually explain why he helped Billy kill Sydney's mum. And in Scream 3, it's revealed that Roman Bridger was actually responsible for setting up the whole murder. So he was actually the puppet master in that scenario. Roman also mentioned to Sydney that he had told Billy to get an accomplice so that he could blame him for all the crimes if the plan went wrong. And obviously, to the audience, it was pretty obvious that that accomplice was Stu. But Stu's motivations for killing were actually pretty much a mystery. There are a few scenarios that could work. And whilst I was doing this video, I was trying to actually research some real life killers. Two people being involved in murders, it's always believed that one is a ringleader and one tends to be a follower. But what I've noticed is that in most cases when two people are killing, especially when it's say two friends, one of them actually has already got the tendency in them to be quite cruel. Usually one of them can be quite vulnerable. I believe in this instance that Stu Macher was the more vulnerable of the two, and I think that maybe in some ways we'll never know. Maybe there was stuff that was going on with Stu that we just didn't know. I mean, his parents weren't actually around for the party at Stu's house. Sydney's dad, I know that he'd gone missing, but he was always relatively there for his daughter. Billy's dad was around as well. Tatum's mum was around. Whereas Stu's parents weren't actually there, which sort of made me believe that maybe these parents sort of abandoned Stu quite a bit. Maybe they left him from time to time. Maybe Stu had some sort of past that we just didn't know about that made him vulnerable, and perhaps they made him quite hateful towards people. Maybe that hatred towards people was already in him before Billy got to him, and then maybe the friendship between him and Billy elaborated into a whole killing spree. And maybe as well, because of the situation with Stu's parents, maybe they weren't overly parental to him, hence why he was so worried about, my mum and dad are going to be so mad at me over the killings. Maybe he was afraid of them, and maybe he didn't take rejection that well through it, hence why when Casey rejected him, he didn't take it all that well at all, and also was in denial, trying to make out that he was the one who dumped Casey for Tatum. But in reality, he must have been so distraught by this rejection that he decided to then go, and then he decided to kill Casey and Stephen off. But also what's interesting as well, if you guys take a very close look at the ending scene, the climax in the kitchen in Scream 1, I find it interesting how Stu wasn't overly trusting of Billy.
Give me the knife.
He didn't trust him over the stabbing situation, because I know that Billy had sort of gone too deep when he stabbed him, and Stu was aware of that. But interestingly enough, he didn't trust Billy enough to give him the knife back, which does kind of hint that maybe he wasn't all that psychotic, but there was definitely something there that he was afraid of Billy, which just highlights peer pressure obviously did play a part in this story. But overall, I would like to conclude and say that I think that Stu's the most interesting killer, because there was no clear motive other than that he was doing it for his friend. And because there's no motive, as Billy said, it's a lot scarier when there isn't a motive. What's your thoughts on this? Do you think that Stu was perhaps neglected by his parents somehow, maybe in his childhood or maybe throughout his life, that's actually led him to behave in the way that he did and actually pushed him over the edge to start a killing spree? Because as I pointed out in the video, the parents weren't present in this movie. There was nobody at that house. Nobody seemed to be there. And it seemed like the house, even though Stu was in it, they didn't even come back later at night. There was nobody there to witness the killings in there. And even at the end of the climax of the movie, when it was daylight, there was no normal cars there except from cars that were already there, which meant that his parents were not coming back that day. So Stu was left alone. So does that indicate something far more darker between Stu and his parents? What do you guys think? I really want to know your thoughts on this. I've seen a lot of theories around as well that Stu was romantically interested in Billy, but none of that seems to be there evidence-wise, so I'm not really going to go with that theory. Thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget to hit the like button. That really does help these videos out. And be sure to go on my channel right now if you're new, because there's far more Scream content on there, and I'm uploading them quite frequently as well. This channel is dedicated to Scream fans, and the whole channel is set up to discuss the four Scream movies and the TV show to an extent. And closing off this video, let's throw in a Stu Macher quote.
Kizu, kiss Kizu, it is out.